It's your boy St. Joe, SansaGita.com. I just want to show you real quick how I got this set up. As you see on my A group, I got the first sound going to MIDI channel 1. And then my B group, I got it going to MIDI channel 2. Just go in there and set the MIDI out, whatever. But if you see, that's actually FM8. What I do is I got it loaded up. Let me pull this over here for you. Close that. So this is what my Reaper looks like. It's just a rack, and I got my, 16 channels, and they each go to, they're each receiving MIDI from machines. So I got my MIDI input set to MIDI controller in, and each channel, 1, 2, 3, all the way down to 16, basically, and all I have to do is just add my, I saved it as a template, called it a machine VST, what I call it? Machine VST rack. So basically, I just got it set like that. And I also have it set like my other template where it's going to record the output instead of the input. It monitors the input, but it's set to record the output. So if I want to track out, I can just push play on machine and it'll record my tracks into waves. Only thing, I mean, it's really like using the MPC how I would set up the MPC to use VSTs. I got a physical MIDI cable on the back of machine going to the in and out, and then that's all I needed. Once I did that, this just works. So let's say I wanted to, anytime I want to look at the VST, if I click it, it pops up right there just like it would be if it was in machine. Same thing with my bass, pops up over there. Or if I wanted to, put something on bank C, group C, if I want to do a MIDI out, put it on 3, say I want to put a new one, all I have to do is go in here. Actually, let me show you what it looks like when I do it. In Reaper, all you got to do is click right here. I mean, I can layer as many plugins as I want on each channel. All you do is do this here, click that, and this comes up. But I have machine on my big monitor and Reaper's chilling on my laptop monitor, so all I gotta do is look over there, pull it up, go through. I got my folders set up, so I got my keyboards, my beat machines, my synths, workstations, bass, whatever. I don't have any strings yet, but any string VSTs or whatever. And then I would just put it in there and it would be on that channel. You don't have to do it by group. You can dedicate one full group to all your MIDI VSTs or whatever, but it works fine. The way I'm able to get this to work is I have a little sound blaster interface USB that I got for my videos, so I can record directly the streaming audio. So I use that for machine. I got that going into my mixer, and then I use the internal interface for Reaper. So I have a mixer, I have both of them going into my mixer. I have two separate audio interfaces, one internal and one USB. And they're both using ASIO drivers, so it works in time. I mean, it would be easier. I would be able to show you better, but I got machine running and I got Reaper running VSTs. Plus, I'm doing this Camtasia, so it's not as clear as it is when I'm not running Camtasia. I'll probably do another one. Matter of fact, I'm gonna kill this. I just wanted to show you how it looks. I'm gonna kill this and then I'm gonna do a regular video showing you how it works and how it sounds together or whatever. So I just wanted to show you how to set it up. Basically, it's the same as my other one. You just set up your MIDI out. Using the MIDI out, set the channels. You can rename it so you know what it is. I got mine set up in groups, but you can do one group and have all your MIDI in there. I really would like to see since we can use MIDI, if we could do it where we could use each pattern of a group separately in the scene arrange. So like we could take sound 1, sound 2, and we don't have to make a pattern with all the sounds in it. We could just treat each sound as its own pattern. Then I wouldn't have no problem using one group, but whatever. But anyway, so I'm gonna show you how it looks and how it works on a regular video, so you can see. I just wanted to show you the interface. and show you how I got it set up in Reaper. And anybody that wants this template, you're more than welcome to have it. It's already set up to respond to Reaper's, I mean, to machines channels, and I don't have any transport. I don't have to do anything. I can do the start, stop, and everything from in machine. All I got to do is save two files, which isn't bad. I used to have to save a lot more than that with my MPC. It's very quick. So I'm gonna end this, and then I'm gonna show you the real. I mean, I'm gonna show you how it works, real time or whatever. Peace.
Yo, so this is what I was showing you. I had it all set up, but running Camtasia and Reaper and Machine and VSTs, put my little laptop to shame, so I couldn't really show you how, the sound. But you can see I can start and stop. So the bass and the brass or whatever, the brass is coming from FM8. The bass is coming from another VST. I got my start stop the way I like to work. So it's really like I would work with the MPC or whatever to sequence VSTs. But you don't have to worry about everything's already on the computer. You know what I'm saying? And I already got it set up at Reaper, so I can, when I'm ready to record, I just hit record and hit play on machine, and it'll record the output of the VSTs. So I can work back and forth with the VSTs and the internal machine sounds very easy. So I'm loving it right now. So yeah, I mean, it works. There's no lag and none of that, no latency. I mean, it feels just like I'm using the VSTs inside machine. So next I'm gonna figure out how I can virtually route machine outputs into Reaper, and then I can record everything at once. But you don't have to do that. I can always export what's in Reaper. I mean, what's in machine. So it's your boy St. Joe, soundsofgear.com, showing you how I use machine standalone to sequence VSTs using Reaper as a VST rack. Dope. If anybody wants a template, just let me know. You can have it. All right. Peace.